Orcas are found in all of the world's oceans, with regional populations differing in their population size, diet, behavior, lifestyle, and the specific threats they may face. The more knowledge is available on these populations, the more work can be done towards their conservation. In Norway, orcas are found in large numbers, especially in the winter when they follow the herring migration into the fjords above the Arctic Circle. Orcas have been studied during this winter month since 1986. Each winter, the same orca groups return to feed on herring. These groups use remarkably specialized techniques to efficiently feed on herring. You may have heard of the so-called carousel feeding. In this technique, orcas work as a team to herd the herring into a tide ball close to the surface. Once the ball is tight enough, they use their special weapon. They charge the edges of the ball and deliver a powerful tail slap that stuns the herring. This way, they can just pick and eat the stunned herring one by one. Until recently, the assumption was that Norwegian orcas mainly feed on herring all year round. But with all the different prey types found in the Norwegian Sea, this was hard to believe. Well, actually, it turns out no one had been researching orcas outside of the winter months in Norway before. This is exactly why the Norwegian Orca Survey was created, to document orcas' diet and ecology in all seasons in Norway, and also to re-establish the long-term photo ID project initiated by colleagues in the late 80s. Since 2013, we have been able to maintain our efforts at sea not only in the winter, but in all seasons, doing photo ID, biopsy sampling, and tagging. We have identified and cataloged over 1,200 orcas, all apparently adopting various diets. Most orcas were visiting the coastal fjords in the winter to feed on herring. But while most of them left the area with the herring, some groups also remained in the north and switched diets. We found that seals were an important food source for some groups. In contrast with other regions, seal-eating orcas in Norway seem to adopt a mixed diet that also includes fish. They also commonly interact and travel with other orcas that may have a different diet. Perhaps our most astonishing discovery was that several groups feed on lumpfish, or lumpsucker. This fish had never been documented as prey to Norwegian orcas before. But why is this such a special finding? Well, if we have a look at a lumpfish, we realize that there's not a lot of tissue to feed on. In fact, this is not what orcas are after. This is what they take, the eggs, or caviar. The whales are actually opening the fish, emptying it for its eggs, and then dropping the fish carcass, which can be picked up and be a great entertainment for youngsters. All this is without mentioning all other surprises and amazing encounters orcas gave us. But there is still much to learn about orcas in Norway. In the coming years, we are hoping to learn more about their health and the trend of this population so that we can help protect them